All right, Valor Lakefront, here we go. I'm recording this really early in the morning. I had to leave the missus off at the airport for a red-eye flight, and I figured now's a good time to do some recording. Let's see what's around here. A lot of grass. Updates. I left Raldos and Kefpint off at the Pookie Daycare Centre to try and get them to some extra experience that they're not getting elsewhere. So a lot of stuff I'm coming up against isn't really good for a fire Pokemon to go up against. It's water Pokemon, it's rock types, and things like that. So, you know, I don't really want to put Raldos out in that. And I figured getting a Stunky leveled up might not be a bad plan. Now, I don't actually know where I'm going here. I assume I've got to make my way south to Route 213. Alright, can't go that way then. So it's Route 213. This is still on Lakefront E. Now, I don't really like swimming in the sea that much either. And I'm going to assume I don't actually have to find that person's key for them. I don't know if I can be bothered doing little side quests like that. Okay. Let's have a look around, I suppose. That doesn't scream hidden item to you. A red shard, I don't know what that is. I was under the impression I was meant to have a fight against someone from Team Galactic there, but never mind. Am I gonna beat up a kid's Pokemon? I think I am. Yep. Yeah, I'm recording this one on the day it's supposed to go out because I've been an idiot and focused all my energy on the Skies of Arcadia playthrough. Ah, Hyperfang, bloody hell, fuck off. No! Don't do that! No. I haven't had any Pokemon footage recorded on this day of release, so... need to get back on top of that. I've got an entire week to myself, though, that I'm going to do a lot of recording. And Mrs. is on a course in London. So, you know, lots of time to myself. I'm sure there's something more useful I could be doing with my time. Don't care. Just gonna be an army of Shellos. I think the next gym is actually a water gym, so definitely worth getting Belknap level up. So close. How many Pokemon in this game know hidden power, I wonder? Mega Drain would have knocked it out at one hit. Sorry, I'm yawning away here. It's stupid o'clock in the morning. I really should go back to bed. That would have been a smart plan. But I'm awake, filled with McDonald's breakfast, for better or worse. I'm doing this because I love you guys. You, I'm worried about me, it's your Pokemon. What's their excuse? Sorry to interrupt your fishing. Really? Guess we're doing this. I found out in the last episode I was having trouble with Pokemon using Flail. Now the problem is the Flail gets stronger the less HP the user of it has. So because I was nearly knocking the guys out in one hit and then they used Flail, they were doing massive amounts of damage to me. Beam raid. What? Ugh. Yee. Get away. I don't like it. Don't like it. That's like the stuff of nightmares, that fish. It's like that thing in the Amazon that swims upstream in the hollow. Bites your willy. Alright, no mucking about with this one. Giga Drain. Huh. Ow. Ow. Of course it's not water type, it's dragon type, isn't it? Right. If in doubt, go for sheer level. Why do I need to have more respect for you? When your Pokemon are so clearly so terrible. What have you got to say for yourself? A bunch of hippie crap. I'm guessing all the Pokemon in this route, I have to go into the water to get them. It'd be worth having a good water Pokemon, because Splurfy doesn't really count as a good water Pokemon. Belnaf's not really. Well, I suppose that was pretty strong, but there's a bit of a level difference. Belnaf really only gets decent when you're facing things it's weak against, or it's strong against, that are weak against it. You know what I mean? Rock types and water types. That's why I talk. Oh, of course, I don't have anyone who knows Smash anymore. Oh, wrong one. Do I know anyone who can learn it? Splurfy can learn it. God, Rock Smash is terrible. I suppose if I've got a dark Pokemon, an actual dedicated one, I don't need Splurfy to know Crunch, a dark move. I completely forgot I've lost Pokemon. Aerial Ace. I already have a Pokemon who knows Aerial Ace. Yeah, there's gotta be a move to Rock Climb or something, I guess. A Honey Tree, okay. I play so sporadically, it's really not worth me going to those Honey Trees. Let's have a little wander around and see what's here. A Wingull! Ah, Wingulls are kind of cute. I like them. Gotta be careful not to kill it. Oh no, I'm grass type. I need to be careful it doesn't kill me. That might be enough. Either way, Route 213, now no longer somewhere I can catch Pokemon. Hey! Means if I come up against something electric, it's absolutely screwed. I'm gonna kill you. Flap flap. Right. There we go. New Pokemon. You gotta save for yourself. It's not that long. Okay. Hey, get to the door! Come on! God, doors are so... Doors are like my big weakness in this game. What's this? Observatory gate. Come on, get in the bloody door! Why am I so bad with doors? So this is where the safari park is. You know what? Let's go see what's what. So another one of these puzzle gyms. So let's see what you guys got. Weasel. Weasel. Yeah, I'm not messing around with this gym. Giga Drain or nothing. I mean, I'll need to run out and restore everyone's PP by the end of this. Hey! The fact that his Buizel was that level makes me worry. Surely the gym leader's Pokemon is going to be much higher than that. Arbok. That also looks like something I don't want to mess with in the river. At least Belmop's getting the first move in each time. That is a really weird, deep sound as well. What can I say? I'm brilliant. Why does everything have to be a bloody maze in this? Why can't we just have a simple gym? This provides us with some problems because it's flying. This is gonna hurt. Not as much as I thought it would. Wow, Winkles are terrible. Yeah, that would register as super effective because the flying type will get us some defense. Another Wingo. Same level. Same plan. At least I know I can withstand a wing attack from a Wingo. Does Wingo maybe not get stab bonus? Stab bonus. Of course it's stab bonus. The bean stab stats for bonus. Does it not get stab from flying attacks? Maybe? You already, haven't I? Okay. No. So my times fighting against Bronzor earlier on got me thinking, what would be the worst, what's the cheapest combination of types that there is? You know, what two types combined together just like nullify any weaknesses they have? I mean, Bronzor is pretty close to getting that award. Like, I can't remember if it's pure steel or not. Steel something else, but it's not overly damaged by fire. That might just be good for fighting in the rain now. Bye bye, Marill. I made a paper mache one of those, like a plaster of Paris sort of thing, in art class once. About the only good thing I ever did in art. I am not artistic in any way. I can play music, but you know, that's what it is. Balloon! These things no flail. Gotta knock them out quick. Hopefully now that you're stronger, Mega Drain will do the trick. Yes. The worst thing is to leave them with 1 HP and let them use Flail. Absorb's useful just for mopping up the ends of a battle when it's got low HP and I don't want to waste the small amount of PP that Mega Drain and Giga Drain have. I can't forget Cut. There's not an option. Maybe it's worth forgetting Mega Drain. No. No. No toxic spikes for you. Ah! Hello! Goodbye! I'm not hanging around here. I saw what that one out on Route 213 nearly did. It was quite strong. Huh. I remember Thrash being a... okay, it's not bad. It's fine. Fly.
Whee!
Missed. Oh, it confused itself. Excellent. Yes! Ah, fly is really strong. Any stronger than the one in Veilstone did. I think this is the last guy to face before the gym leader. Oh. I feel bad taking them out, because they're so cute. I really like them. Don't like them enough to spare them, but I really like them. Absorb is good. I don't want to waste a turn with Mega Drain. Giga Drain. Absorb's definitely going to be enough to knock it out. I get a fair bit of HP back from that. Into this gym to throw people who came in here with grass types for a loop. It's the only explanation I can give. Because there's no way you'd do that if you're expecting people with electric Pokemon to come through. Might as well use Giga Drain if this is the last fight before the main gym leader. Run out to the Pokémon Center. Oh, so close. Getting a nice bit of cash here, which is nice. Stays at this level when I come back. I cannot be bothered doing all that again. But we'll see you next time on Nuzlocke.